Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button because the World Series is here. And man, two seasons and we're already at the World Series. I mean, couldn't go better. We are overachieving by a little bit, I think, in my opinion. Probably by a lot, to be honest. But I mean, we made it here and I'm not complaining. So let's look at the ALCS. So the good thing about going into this World Series, we do get that extra DH spot for at least half the game. So you can see here, it's the Houston Astros versus the New York Yankees, and the Yankees do not have home field advantage. So in the first game, ends up being Justin Verlander, I believe, versus Tanaka. Let me just see who's there. Actually, it's versus Severino. So Verlander versus Severino, and look at this. It was McCullers versus Severino. And Houston wins game one. So they take game one. So I was mistaken. Actually, New York has home field advantage. So they end up winning the second game in this series, 12-6. You see they had 104 wins. I mean, they straight like killed it. And you can see here, Aaron Judge, 2-for-4, 3 RBIs. I'm guessing one of those was a home run. I'm just guessing. But look at their lineup. I mean, Kike Hernandez? I don't even know. But then they have Judge, Stanton, Sanchez, Castellanos. I mean, just all over. Tim Beckham, Aaron Hicks, Adrian Gonzalez. I mean, they got a squad. So let's move on to game three. So then in game three, they are on the road this game, the Yankees at Houston. They win this one 5-4. Look at all the hits that are going on in this series. 13 hits to 12 hits. You could see everybody in their top four in their lineup got at least two hits. I mean, that's going to win you a game no matter what. You see Altuve is only hitting 272 up to this point. They actually got Rhys Hoskins too, and he's hitting 444 in the playoffs. So maybe they aren't getting the production out of Altuve that they need in this series, but they're going to need it going into game four. So here in game four, they get what they needed. So they got the win 9-3 off of 14 hits. Altuve this time goes 2-for-5. Carlos Correa goes 3-for-4 with 3 RBIs. Hoskins goes 1-for-4 as well. So he is at 419 in the playoffs. And I mean, great game by them. I mean, Mariznick goes 3-for-4. Let's look at their pitching in this one. So it looks like Allard pitched 6 innings, 4 strikeouts, only giving up 3 hits. So he pitched a pretty good game. Looks like Sonny Gray actually pitched 4, and he gave up 6 earned. So let's move on to game 5. So here in game 5, the last game in Houston, it looks like Houston could not get enough runs across the board, but they got 12 hits. I mean, so many hits. I really hope that this isn't going to be a tough matchup. I mean, it will be. I mean, both these teams just exploding on offense. You can see Kike Hernandez with 3-for-6, but that's, I mean, if you have a guy that goes 3-for-6, you're going to win it. I mean, pretty much. I mean, that means your leadoff guy's getting on. The likelihood he's going to score with Judge and Stanton, I mean, look at Stanton. He went 1-for-4, 4 RBIs. So I'm guessing he hits some type of grand slam there. And they go on to win this game. So let's go on to game 6. So here in game 6, the Yankees are back in the World Series. And I mean, it's been actually kind of a while since I've seen the Yankees in the World Series. And they're finally back there. I think this is the first time in the World Series since Derek Jeter. And I mean, Houston could not pull it off. They actually had an okay season compared to what they've been having the last couple years. 87-75. Isn't their greatest. And you see, I mean, just look at what Kike Hernandez is doing. 3-for-4. Stanton's going 2-for-3. So he gets to face his former team. We get to face, who knew? I mean, we get to face Stanton 2 years after he left us. So you see here, Cole pitched 5 2/3 innings, strikes out 7, but gives up 8 hits. And then Keuchel pitches 6 2/3, 7 hits, only 2 earned runs. So we are facing the Yankees in this World Series. So let's look at our statistics going into this World Series. So Josh Bell is hitting 368 in the playoffs, hitting pretty good. Domingo Santana right behind him, hitting 359. Justin Bour's hitting 333. And like I said, we're going to have to answer some questions here. What are we going to do with Josh Bell and Justin Bour? I mean, two first basemen we have. I'm only going to play one of them at first base. The other one, I don't know, because, I mean, it's going to be tough. I don't know what I'm going to do. John Giovatella is actually hitting 290 with 31 at-bats. Manny Machado, this is where it dips off a little bit, 235. Adrian Beltre is hitting 226. Lewis Brinson's only hitting 205. Hopefully he can turn around. JT Realmuto, back to his old ways. And you know what's funny? In that first series, I thought that he would kind of turn a corner and towards the end of the season, but no, he's back to hitting 176. Danny Valencia, 143. Jungho Kang is hitting 125, and not too many at-bats from our bench players. So looking at our pitchers, 3-0 for Michael Fulmer. DeSclafani, 1-0. Let's just look at the strikeouts here to walk ratio. I mean, this is where we shine here. 13 strikeouts to one walk by Michael Fulmer. DeSclafani, 10 strikeouts to no walks. Drew Steckenrider actually had a pretty good series out of the bullpen. 0.028 whip. I mean, that man just has been killing it in the playoffs, and I think he's earned himself a new contract, at least a renewal in his contract. We'll see how that goes in offseason. Harleen Garcia, 11-3. I mean, not too bad. 1.57 whip, but a 5.28 ERA. Definitely want to probably get that down. Jose Urania, look at him. 1.59 whip isn't bad. But, I mean, I do like that, you know, he hasn't been pitching too bad in the fourth spot. I do like what he is bringing to our team. He's gone up in overall. He's at 79 now. And look at his strikeouts per nine now. It's up to 54. Remember, it was in the 40s before, so it's good to see him just improving as a whole. So, looking at our bullpen here, Danny Barnes, 117 whip. Bartolo Colon Jr., he's been struggling a little bit. I think he's still getting his feet wet. Edebray Ramos, we're going to need to depend on him. And Trevor Cahill hasn't pitched that much. So let's just skim through the Yankees here. Tim Beckham's hitting 444 for them. Not hitting too bad. Giancarlo Stanton, 364. He's hitting pretty good. And then Aaron Hicks hitting 343. He's at the bottom of the lineup too. Why did I say Kike Hernandez? Cesar Hernandez is hitting 310. I don't know why I said Kike earlier. Gary Sanchez hitting 303. So, I mean, their top hitters are all hitting over 300. So, man. Marwin Gonzalez, I don't even think he's a starter. He's coming off the bench, I think. Maybe. I'm not even sure. 278. Nick Castellanos hitting 278. And then Aaron Judge hitting 222. Jace Peterson right behind him. So, I mean, this is going to be a tough matchup, man. I can't lie. But they do have home field advantage, so we do get to use that DH right away. So let's hop into this action. Michael Fulmer, Severino, head-to-head, World Series. Here it goes. Let's get it. Let's go. So we've been leaning on Michael Fulmer pretty hard throughout the regular season and playoffs. So hopefully we can provide him with the run support in this series, because it's going to be very, very important to use him as kind of that pitcher that where we can get a win. And especially with your ace, you always want to get a win with your ace. And he's undefeated, but so is Severino. So Severino on the mound for the Yankees. And he's facing Josh Bell here and getting Josh Bell to pop up after the Lewis Brinson strikeout. So up comes Domingo Santana with two outs, 3-2 count. And he swings and misses at the low slider. So Severino gets out of the first inning. No damage done. But we have an ace of our own, Michael Fulmer. And here he is facing Cesar Hernandez to lead off the game. And we do get the ground out. So up comes Jace Peterson in the two-hole at shortstop, and he grounds out. So two outs here early on in this inning, and up comes Aaron Judge, big 6-8, all of him. And on a 1-2 count, he hits a little ground ball to the pitcher. So a 1-2-3 inning for both aces. So now we move on to the bottom of the second inning. No hits given up in this game yet, as we do face our former man. I mean, he was the face of the franchise in Giancarlo Stanton. But right away, we do walk him. We were just talking about how we do not walk. We have not walked anybody, really. And right away, we walk him. So now the next batter comes up, Gary Sanchez, and he gets a hit to the right side. So up comes Nicholas Castellanos, and he's a pretty good hitter. He was one of the guys I was looking to trade for when he played for Detroit. But now he plays for the Yankees, and on a 3-2 count, he hits a little dribbler, but it's just slow enough to allow him to make it to first on the double play attempt, and up comes another good hitter in Marwin Gonzalez, and he gets a hit to the left side, and that brings in the first run of the game, and Marwin Gonzalez came over from the Astros. He gets a hit. So now up comes Tim Beckham, and he's at the bottom of their lineup, and we do get him to strike out looking at the high heat that time. So with two outs, up comes Aaron Hicks, and he hits one up the middle. That one's going to be off Michael Fulmer, and he's going to beat that one out. So bases loaded here, back at the top of the lineup here. Cesar Hernandez, 3-2 count, two outs. He hits a ground ball to Adrian Beltre, but Beltre cannot handle that one, and two runs are going to come in as the runners were on the move, and that is going to be a 3-0 lead off of that error. So now up comes Jace Peterson, and he comes through with the hit. And look at Leary Garcia in left field. He gets the start in left field, and right away, no different than Josh Bell. We've seen this way too much. Our corner outfielders are making too many errors, as that one costs us another two runs. So it is 5-0 as big Aaron Judge comes up and takes one deep to right field. And man, 7-0, what a can of worms that has been open on us. I mean, we were at 1-0. I was fine with that. But then that Adrian Beltre error at third base allowed six more runs to come across the plate. As we finally get out of this inning, as Giancarlo Stanton swings at an outside slider. So we got a lot of ground to make up in this game, as Josh Bell comes up and he pops one up to center field. That's an easy out. Domingo Santana comes up with a 3-2 count, and he finally gets a hit. So not a bad start here. We need some base runners. We need a lot of base runners, to be honest. But down 7 runs here in the fourth inning, we definitely have a lot of time, but it's pretty unlikely. When is the last time a 7-run deficit has been blown in the World Series, as we do pop up the shortstop? So now up comes Justin Bour with a 3-2 count with two outs, and he gets walked. So now guys on first and second here with JT Realmuto. Remember, we showed that he's been struggling as of late. He hits one hard up the middle, but that one is going to be stopped by Tim Beckham there at second base, and we're going to get out of this inning. No run. So here comes Josh Bell up, playing him in the DH spot in the sixth inning. And can he get anything going? He gets a pitch to hit right down the middle, but that just didn't have any legs. I thought that was pretty much gone off of his bat, but I guess it's just right to the right fielder. Routine fly ball. So up comes Domingo Santana, and he gets an inside fastball. He walks. So then up comes Manny Machado, the MVP. He walks. So up comes Justin Bour, 3-2 count. One out. Will he draw a walk too? But he gets a hold of one down the left field line, and Justin Bour is just going to be foul. That one was close, but he does recover. Hits a hard one to left field, but right to the left fielder. Severino is just doing his thing on the mound, getting us out any way possible, as JT Realmuto gets a slider over the middle, but an easy ground ball to third base. So Severino is dealing. So now on to the bottom of the seventh inning. I do decide to pull Michael Fulmer early on in this game. I think I pulled him after the fourth inning just to get him out of there and get his energy back up, because, I mean, the way this game is looking, I probably won't need him to pitch a lot of innings. So I get him out of there, save him for maybe game four or so. And up comes Gary Sanchez after two strikeouts to Judge and Stanton. I mean, they have three great power hitters, and he takes them deep. I mean, I can't get past this line. This is the death lineup. They are hitting the ball hard every single time. They have three guys who can go deep on any pitch. They literally can go back to back to back at any moment. And this is going to be a tough series for us, as we are down 8-0 here in the eighth inning. And here is a pitcher out of the bullpen. We're facing somebody else other than Severino, and he's getting into a little bit of trouble. Walking our first two batters are 3-4 hitters, and then one more time, Justin Bour gets walked. So now bases loaded with no outs, and they decide to bring in Jonathan Holder out of the bullpen to face JT Realmuto. So with no outs, 1-1 count, he gets a pitch to hit right over the middle, but pops it up to the infield. So now they got One out here in the inning, 1-2 count. Adrian Beltre comes to the plate. He hits a little pop fly to center, but that one's actually going to drop, and that's going to be a run score. And look at the center fielder. He threw it to the pitcher, threw it to the cutoff man instead of throwing to second base. He could have had an easy out at second base, but he chooses not to, and he gives us new life. But with the bases loaded, one out, we still can't drive another run. So one run comes out of a bases loaded, no out inning. So now they bring us to the ninth inning here. Johnny Vedder's here on the mound, and I mean, the way we're swinging the bat, no hope for us as he gets Lewis Brinson to strike out. Then he gets Josh Bell to strike out as well. One more out in the game, and he's gonna get that. I mean, this death lineup did its thing in the second inning. All they needed was one huge inning, and the Yankees get it done in the first game of this World Series. And we got to get going with our offense. I mean, Severino pitched a pretty good game. I gotta give him credit. But I mean, our offense just didn't do enough. We had 6 hits. We knew they would be a team that's going to produce a lot of hits. They had 13. And I mean, it was just an onslaught from the beginning. And they didn't look back. I mean, their pitching stepped up, was pretty good with Severino. We just didn't come through. So hit subscribe, hit that like button, because we're coming through next video. Game 2, maybe 3-2 as well. So we'll see. We got to come back. This is going to be a tough series for us, tough matchup. They got the death lineup versus the overachieving Marlins. Can we pull off a miracle in this series? Well, stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.